Hello students, in this video I will be explaining about waveguides. So you can see this is the sample or a figure which shows the basic nature of waveguide, basic structure in which the x-axis shows its width and y-axis shows its height. And in this figure, the width in x direction is A and the height in y direction is B. So A indicates its width and B indicates its height. I will show you another figure. From that you will be getting an example that how it will be used in practical applications. So this is the practical waveguide which is used to guide the electromagnetic wave in particular direction. This is a straight waveguide, practical waveguide, which may be interconnected to multiple waveguides to guide the electromagnetic wave in particular direction. This is another example of practical waveguide. In this it is shown vertical, so it can be used as per need. So now we will be deriving the wave equations. The derivation is quite large, so I will be deriving only the first single equation. So it can be started with the Maxwell's first equation, and that is del cross H equals to j omega epsilon Es. The left hand side is cross product, so it can be expanded as del by del y of hz s minus del by del z of hys. Actually this expression can be easily expanded using the determinant. So if you arrange ax unit vector ax ay az in the first row of determinant, and similarly the del by del x, del by del y and del by z, del z in second row, and similarly h x s h y s and h z s in third row of determinant, and if you solve that you will get this expression. Now the right hand side of this equal sign can be easily expanded as e x s into a x e y s into unit vector a y, that is written d y, but it is a unit vector a y, and EZS is unit vector into unit vector AZ. Now we can equate the x direct components of same directions on both sides. The AX component and AX component of both sides x can be equated as this, the bracket, the first bracket on left hand side. Similarly on right hand side j omega epsilon into exs. Similarly we can equate the y and z components also like this. This is y component and this is z component. This is all about Maxwell's first equation. Now we can go to Maxwell's second equation. This is Maxwell's second equation in phasor form. So the left hand side can be expanded similar to the first equation as this, and the right hand side will be expanded like this. Now we will equate both sides and we will take out the x, y and z components. This is x component, this is y component and this is z component. So we got six equations, three equations from first Maxwell's first equation and these three equations from Maxwell's second equation. Now the wave equation, second order wave equation for E field is this. This is the second order wave equation for E field. This delta square, actually it is Nabla. Delta square is second order differential equation and it is called as wave equation. So we can write this equation as del square by del x square es plus del square by del y square ey plus del square by del z square es, and on right hand side it is minus omega square mu epsilon es. Now similarly we have wave equation for H field similar to the E field as this, and the expansion of this will be similar to E field like this. Now solution of wave equation will be EYS equals to EY0 into e to the power minus gamma z. This is solution of wave equation for E field in y direction. So if I differentiate the equation EYS both sides, or yes, on both sides, I will get del by del z of EYS equals to EY0 is constant, so it will be taken out, and derivative of e to the power minus gamma z is e to the power minus gamma z into minus gamma. So the term, so this term EY0 into minus gamma into gamma, the term EY0 into e to the power minus gamma z is actually EYS. So I can put EYS in this place. So this can be like this. So it will be minus gamma into EYS. So I can write the same equation for H also. But before that, for X, this is the solution of wave equation for E field in X direction. Now this is for H, solution of wave equation for H field in Y direction. Similarly in X direction, the solution of wave equation for H field will be this much. Now these are the four wave equations, solution of wave equations. So these are the solution of wave equation for E and H field in X and Y direction. Now you can remember that we have started with Maxwell's first and second equation, and where we got 3 and 3, total 6 equations. So I can write the Maxwell's second equation, this is the Maxwell's first equation, solution from Maxwell's first equation. So you may remember that in first slide we started with Maxwell's first equation, and where we got three equations. These are the three equations. Now I can put the values here. You can see the Maxwell's first equation, this equation, it has z. Here it has z, and in all the four equations we have z. So we will try to put these values in this equation. So we will get the first equation as this: del by del y hz is equals to gamma hys, because we have substituted the third equation, del by del z hys. We have substituted this equation here in the first equation, and in the second equation we have z term here. So we'll put del by del x, put this equation, but here it is written hys, so we'll put here. So we'll get the equation like this. By mistake here it is written hys, this equation here it is written by mistake, it will be del hy, instead of hys it will be hxs divided by del z, and on right hand side it will be minus gamma hxs. So if you put this equation here, we will get this value. And in the third equation, here it is del x and del y, but we don't have any equation for that, so that it will remain as it is. Now we will consider the three equations that we got from Maxwell's second equation. These are the three equations that we got from Maxwell's second equation. Now we will put using these four equations on left hand side. We have here del z, we have here del z, so we will put in this place. So it will be Ey is the first equation. We'll put the first equation in the first equation right hand side. We'll get like this. And for the second equation, Ex is upon del z, we'll put the second on left hand side. We'll put this equation. So here we'll get like this. And the third equation, we have del x and del y, but we don't have any equation here. So it will remain as it is. Now we'll consider the solution of wave equation, the second order equation. We got some relation there. This was the relation that we got in Maxwell's. We got where solution of wave equation, we were trying to find out the solution of wave equation. We got this relation, and in this we will put del by del z e s, del by del z e s. So for that it will be gamma e s, because you can see that we the e y term and e x term, these are the component in y and x direction. So if we combine these terms, we will get the equation for e, because the term e s, because the term this e s, it can it is splitted in ey and ex components. So if we merge these two, we will get the relation as gamma square es. Now here the term the gamma square es is taken on right hand side, and minus sign is taken out. And now we will assume this gamma square plus omega square mu epsilon as h square. So the equation will become like this: del by del x es plus del square by del y square es equal to minus h square es. This is actually we tried to find out using solution of wave equation for E field. Now for H field, we have this equation. This is the solution of wave equation for H field. So if we put this in the same way, we'll get relation like this. Here we have collected all the relations that we got till now. The above three equations are we got this when we substituted the four equations in Maxwell's first equation, the solutions we received from Maxwell's first equation. Similarly, the next three in orange color, these are the solution of wave equation. These are the wave equations from Maxwell's second equation. And in yellow color, these are the equations from solution of wave equation. So these are the raw materials where from we will get another set of equations that we will use in this unit 5. So in this stuff, we will consider the first equation, the topmost first equation. So this is arranged like this. The right hand side is taken on left hand side, and the term j omega epsilon is taken on other side. So we got the equation for exs. And from the orange color equations, we will take the middle one, because in that we have exs. So I am taking the middle one. Now I will put this exs in this equation here like this. Now manipulating this equation, solving this equation means just opening the bracket, like we'll get like this. If I open the bracket, I will get the equation like this. Now I will take the term HYS on right hand side. You can see this term HYS, it is on left hand side, and there is one term on right hand side HYS. So for combining these two, I need to collect HYS on one side. So this HYS is taken on left hand side, and the common term and the bracket term will remain as minus j omega mu plus gamma square upon j omega epsilon. Then we have started from the first equation. This first equation, from here we started. Now we'll bring HYS from this equation. We will try to find the value of HYS from here, and we'll put it here to get the equation for EXS. We started with the equation of ESS, and we'll end with the equation of EXS. So from this equation, when we substituted this equation in this equation, we got this relation, and from the here we'll try to find HYS, and we'll put HYS in the first equation. So this is our aim. So I have kept this equation EXS here to show that our aim is to find HYS, and this is the previous equation. Now we'll take the term, we have cross multiplied this j omega epsilon and j omega mu. J square is minus 1 and there is minus sign here, which will compensate and become plus sign, and omega into omega, omega square mu epsilon will be there, plus gamma square upon j omega epsilon. Now this term will be taken on right hand side. Now before that, we can remember that in previous slide we have assumed that gamma square plus omega square mu epsilon as h square. So we have substituted here. Here this is the assumption. Now we have taken this h square upon j omega epsilon on right hand side. So we got the equation for HYS. Now we'll put this in the equation of EXS. So here we have equation of EXS. We got the relation for HYS. We'll put it here. Now we'll expand the equation. We'll open the bracket. So we'll get this equation like this. 1 upon j omega epsilon at as it is, del by del y hz as it is, this minus sign will come out, and gamma into j omega epsilon, this will be here, and similarly minus sign will come out, and gamma into gamma is gamma square, and h square is as it is, del by hzs. Now in this we have taken this hzs and this hzs common here. So this hzs upon del y is taken out, so here it will be 1, here minus gamma square upon h square will remain as here, gamma square upon h square, and this does the term will remain as it is. Now just we need to adjust the equation to get the final relation. So in this we have to multiply this h square here. Actually the omega epsilon is multiplied by opening the bracket, so it is multiplied with the first relation and will remain as it is, and when it is multiplied with the second relation, the j omega epsilon from numerator and denominator will get cancelled, and we'll get with gamma upon h square. On left hand side here we'll cross multiply h square with 1, so we'll get h square minus gamma square upon h square, we'll get h square minus gamma square upon h square. So h square is remain here as it is, but the h square minus gamma square, in this h square place we'll put the assumption that we already have discussed in the previous slide, as h square equals to gamma square plus omega square mu epsilon. So when we put here h square equal to gamma square plus omega square mu epsilon, the gamma square and gamma square will get cancelled, and here we will be with this equation
omega square mu epsilon upon h square. Now when we have actually solved this equation to get this equation, and from here we got this h square in previous slides, but here we are doing something reverse. So we have substituted h square as omega square mu epsilon, and from here we can adjust like this omega as omega into omega, and we can adjust 2j here with a minus sign, because when we solve this j into j square, and j square is minus 1, and minus minus will get plus. So this adjustment, this is the adjustment. So now when we cross, when we open the bracket, this j omega epsilon and j omega epsilon will get cancelled, and we'll get the relation like this, minus j omega mu upon h square into del by del of hzs. We kept this on right hand side, and minus gamma upon h square into del by del x of ezs on left hand side. So we got this relation for exs. Similarly, we can get the relation for eys and hxs, hys. So this is the first relation. Remaining relation will be explained in another videos. Thank you for now. You are requested to watch the video completely and share this video to your friends, and please do subscribe. Thank you.